It's Sonic Temple Live. From the Rabid Customs Artist Lounge. Powered by number one Rikers with 99.7 The Blitz.
Hey, it is Loper, and I'm live right now in the Rabid Customs Artist Lounge with Mike from Kill Switch Engage. What's up, brother? How you doing,
hey,
man?
Hey, thank you very much for having me. This is awesome.
I'm super stoked that you're here, man. We were just talking off the air. Really excited to see the band tonight. And you were saying that this is it for the tour.
Yeah, this is the last day of the tour. This is actually the first ever for us full U.S. tour. It started in Australia with Parkway Drive. Then we did Europe with Parkway Drive. And then the U.S. Usually we'll do those, but they won't be consecutive. This was consecutive and all the way around the globe. It was pretty neat, but last day, really tired.
But you got to have that like last day, sort of like senior week vibe going, like where you're tired, but you're super pumped at the same time because you're going home.
Oh, yeah. No, we're going to spend every last bit of energy to put on a good show today and go home crying.
So you guys are like literally when it comes to metal, you're like a scientist. You guys are like scientists. You know, the style that you guys play, most people, I think, that are familiar with your music realize how difficult it is to play that style of music. And, you know, out on a tour with you and Parkway Drive, I mean, that is just like absolute killers. That's like a lineup. Did you guys like come up with that yourselves? Did you invite them on the road? How does that work out?
They had actually asked us, and you know, they're from Australia, and that was the original plan, was just to go to Australia with them. But
That's awesome. It
just worked out so well. We said we just kept adding more dates and more places around the world, and super nice guys. I believe they played here yesterday. And
yeah, they did. Oh my God, they were so good.
So jealous of them because they're good in the air flying home now. but really great guys. We would love to do it again with them. Maybe we'll hit another corner market in Japan or something, or China with them.
I love Australia, man. Australia is really cool. The people there, that they are just so accepting of like hard music. They love hard music, it seems like. And I know also I do an MMA podcast, and we have a huge listenership fan base in Australia. And the people there, I mean, they support the show. It's nuts. I mean, do you guys find that when you go to places like Australia that are kind of off the beaten path, so to speak, you get a lot of love?
I think especially there, because they know how hard it is to get there, how expensive it is to get there. Not every band gets there. So when you do actually make it there, they're in heaven. They pull out all the stops, super duper nice people. Love hanging there. Perfect weather. It's like paradise.
So going home, Mike, you're going to be home tomorrow. What's the first thing you do? Do you have hobbies? Like, what are you going to do?
Funny thing, my birthday is tomorrow.
Oh, bro, I just had a birthday, too, on the 15th.
Yeah, we're not going to
Are you
say
a Taurus? Is that a Taurus?
What's that?
Are you still Taurus?
I am still a Taurus. Right. Yeah, May 19th. So I'm going to celebrate my birthday with my girlfriend. It's nice to be able to be home for that.
Nice, man. Do you like any hobbies, any sports? Are you into anything?
I love wrestling. There's a big pay-per-view on tomorrow night, Money in the Bank.
Pro wrestling.
Can't wait for it.
Just at Raw. We went to SmackDown.
Sweet.
And, you know, it's funny. So what do you think about Becky Lynch beating Ronda and Charlotte at WrestleMania?
It's cool.
Was it a clean win?
I didn't think it was a clean win. I'm not the biggest Becky Lynch fan. Charlotte is probably the best wrestler on the roster, so I'd like to see her maybe take something better.
Do you like Ronda in the Fed?
Love it.
Yeah,
I think she's great. She's doing judo moves that no one else is doing. It's refreshing.
Do you ever feel like it's not a shoot sometimes? She's legitimately pissed?
I think so. It looks like she's hurting people left and right, too.
Right.
The way she's flinging people around.
It totally does.
Kofi Kingston was my favorite of WrestleMania.
So you were super pumped when he won the title.
That's a good one. I went to WrestleMania, too.
My second one ever. Have you guys ever done any music for them?
We did a theme song for CM Punk way back 2006 or something like that. I used it for about 6 or 7 years and got a chance to meet him a few times.
Super Phil's
nice
a cool guy.
Really nice. He had come to us about 2 years prior to him switching his theme song to Cult of Personality by Living Color and asked us if we would cover it.
Oh, wow. Is that right?
We were so engaged in touring that we just couldn't make it out to do the song, but he definitely asked us, which was really nice of him.
Dude, he's a cool guy, man. I was front row for his fight. His second fight against Mickey Gall.
Didn't last very long.
Sorry about that, Phil.
Poor guy. I mean, it
was tough. But, you know, here's what I say about him, man. I mean, like, you know, obviously there's debate whether he should have got the shot, right? But you can't deny the absolute heart, dude. I mean, you know what it's like to be in front of a crowd, but then you got to go out there and put it all on the line as a man and fight another dude. Like, are you kidding me?
The amount of ego gumption you have to put in your head to go out there and say, I'm going to do this is impressive. I can't do it. That's why I drink a lot before I go on stage.
I was front row as he was getting the Vaseline on his face. I was like, hey, Phil. Do you want me to take you out of here right now, bro? Like, no, he's a beast, man. I hear he's going to do jiu-jitsu tournaments. I know his coach, jiu-jitsu coach, and like, I mean, he's got that mindset of a real animal.
There's rumors about him going back to wrestling.
I think that's the move, man.
I think it's the best move,
right?
Why not? Why wouldn't you go to AEW? Let's go.
Dude, that's kind of sick, right? They just got that deal on, is it on TNA?
TNT.
Yes. So it's like kind of like old school WCW, right?
Right.
Man, Ted Turner loves some wrestling. I wonder if he'll dump some money into this.
I hope so.
Would you ever do that, like, as somebody in a position of power where folks know you? Would you ever get involved in pro wrestling at any angle, like, since you're a fan?
I would love to. My other band, Death Ray Vision, just did a video in a wrestling ring with a bunch of wrestlers, and it was just smiles all around. The entire day, we were smiling and laughing and having fun, so much so that when I got home, my face hurt. I would love to have that many smiles on my face all day long. So, yeah, I could see something like that happen. Not fighting, that's for sure.
Right. I'll be your manager,
I'm
bro.
I'm way too wimpy.
Yeah. Hey, it's Mike from Killswitch, and we are live right now in the Rabid Customs Artist Lounge. Dude, I thanks so much for spending some time, man.
Thank you so much. And that was fun.
Have fun when you go home.
Oh, great. I will.
Thanks for watching, guys.
Thanks.